By the time I was 6, I'd already made an important discovery that I get along much better with animals than with humans. When I was 12, I began to sketch the libretto for an opera, which would declare my affinity in no uncertain terms. It was going to be about the self-destruction of the human race. It involved the takeover of the planet by species of morally enlightened frogs, fish, and associated reptiles. What I had in mind, I think, was a sort of, well, if the ghost of Richard Strauss will pardon the pun, a sort of aquatic toad of a clown. Sorry about that. There was, however, to be one human character on stage. The part was conceived for a boy soprano, and I'll give you one guess as to who is to get it. Anyway, the opera did not get finished, didn't even get produced, which was perhaps just as well, because the casting problems would probably have been insuperable. Some years later, I was taking a walk along a country road one evening, and as I passed a field in which about 3 or 4 dozen cows were grazing, I happened to be singing to myself a song by Mahler. Oddly enough, it was the song called St. Anthony's Sermon to the Fishes. And as I walked along, I glanced at the cows, and I noticed that they turned, glancing at me. So I stepped up the volume just a bit, and with that, the entire herd converged on the nearest fence. And it was an extraordinarily touching occasion. I really felt that a very special bond had been established. Certainly, I've never encountered so intense.
rules are you playing?
There's only one rule. Expediency. Munt gives London what it needs, so Fiedler dies and Munt lives. It was a foul, foul operation, but it paid off.
Who for?
What the hell do you think spies are? Moral philosophers measuring everything they do against the word of God or Karl Marx? They're not. They're just a bunch of seedy, squalid bastards like me. Little men, drunkards, queers, henpecked husbands, civil servants playing cowboys and Indians to brighten their rotten little lives. Do you think they sit like monks in a cell, balancing right against wrong? Yesterday I would have killed Munt, because I thought him evil and an enemy, but not today. Today he's evil and my friend. London needs him. They need him so that the great moronic masses you admire so much can sleep soundly in their flea-bitten beds again. They need him for the safety of ordinary, crummy people like you and me.
You killed Fiedler!
How big does a cause have to be before you kill your friends? What about your party? There's a few million bodies on that path. think spies are. Moral philosophers measuring everything in your field with God and Karl Marx. They're not Marx. They're just a bunch of CDs, squalid bastards like these. Little ass drunkards, queers, henpecked husbands, civil servants playing cowboys in these systems right in their rotten little lives. the story point of view of the lords on the planet of Dan Centrone. Would be very heavy now in 1977. Plus you add to that that the atomic site right across the river and you've got a perfect sighting area. Well, that seems to follow a rather human pattern. Well, there's nothing saying that the atomic sites across the country seem to attract them. Absolutely. There's a high incidence there. They're not, Dan is a parapsychologist, gathering information. You mean it's possible that they understand our thinking, but we have to get ready for some very extreme ways of thinking, extreme ways of viewing things. They're obviously beyond us in technology. You lead a center in the New York area. You have a command center where people, Westchester and Rockland, the ones that we investigate are about 25 people. We have various means of detecting the presence of, and this is based on the research we did into the occurrence of people in automobiles and their engines. At first, most is kind of nice, but after we basis on paper, not individually, led to investigate, and at that time, 2 years ago, we found that there's a magnetic disturbance, and that magnetic disturbance somehow interferes with the car. But what we've done is we have a detector which will, as a result of the magnetic field interference, close a relay and either automatically set in a set off a camera or set off an alarm, and as a result we're capable now of tracking them by setting up several of these detectors. We're going to use this and then zoom to the atomic site, state of the atomic site, and this is not the first time we've seen them over the atomic site. What about the future? What do you think the future holds for us? It has been predicted. I can't go on just if we're. I must go on when we're, because I put a lot of preparation to it. And I also would like to establish the fact that there's no doubt in my mind at all. It would have to be, as I mentioned before, scientific cowardice for someone to look at all the advice of intact. What will happen?
I think that there'll be a eighth day of creation type. I think that that's a catch-all phrase, meaning our next...
At the Kennedy Space Center in Cape Canaveral, near the giant Saturn V rocket, I met with Dr. Richard Yinger.
We'll be right back.